Hello, this is Dale in 75 Games. Welcome back to another Europa Universalis 4 Let's Play video. I am currently Germania and fighting against England. We have territory in England already over in Britain, and we are just trying to expand, especially before they take over all the little guys, which is what they're doing right now. They've been expanding. They've probably taken two or three or four counties, or provinces, I keep saying counties. Now I have to call it provinces. It took me forever to start calling them counties in CK2. Okay, so the army is moving there. Fleet's moving over here to hit theirs. Right there. They're blockading Munster with... Okay, we did... We're working way at London. It's not their capital yet, though. But they're moving. I think they see us. They're moving. We won't get there in time, but... So I had... There was a thing that was ticked that automatically raised maintenance during war. That says fine, but it also... activates all my forts, which really lowers my monthly income. So it was at like 1, now it's at 15.9. Let's take this back. I want to kill that army. Let's move the... No, let's move the, this guy. I'm gonna sit there and siege, actually. Now, here comes the army again. Anyways, let's crush this army. Damn it, I didn't get the reinforcement because it's fighting. They are moving quite a few soldiers into there. Okay, I'm gonna... No. I guess so, you know what? Do it. It's asking if I want my fleet to transport that army. I guess so. We'll hit this, let this reinforce a bit, and then we'll go up there. So we can core another one. There, it's the last one. But we're going to get a few from this. I would like to take London, we have that, and Kent. Those should be cheap. Truce with Brunswick. What? What's going on? What happened? Are they allied with England? Oh, I'm not... Okay. No, they're at 200. You need to be at peace with them, and we need 5 years. You know, everything's going good there. One thing I haven't looked at... Here, it's right here, subject. So we have the Jatvingia. Siphon income. Ooh. Enable support loyalists. Reduce liberty desire by 20. What is their liberty desire? I have to look at it. Their opinion of us. I actually don't want Jatvingia. So Brunswick is paying us 26 per month. This is change. Placate local rulers. This is liberty. Okay, so that's at 0. They don't really care. I can enable scutage. Is this per month? Yeah, 0.26. That means that they pay additional 50%, but they have no army that comes to help me out. It's not like it really helps out that much. But I wanted to order them, not just interact. Okay, here it is. Military focus for subjects. Decide on their own strategies. No, I always want them supportive. I always like this. Unless they're really big, then they can go and do their own thing. So this has... replenished a little bit. Our manpower is coming back. See, they have a large army coming in. This is exactly why I want it to replenish. They may try to go for one of the armies here. I have to watch that. No, he's just sitting there. This should be finished. There. Okay, so this is what I wanted. Surprisingly more... armies than I thought. They have larger armies than I thought they would. But they also have Mercia and Lothian with them. They only have about 11,000 English armies. Can we go there? No. Why can't this guy go there? Yeah, he can. 19th October. 19th October. Oh, they're going to stay for it. They'll probably bring in this army to help them out. Well, our morale is a lot higher than theirs. but it's not going as well as it should. Yeah, now it's going better. Because they were defending, we had a lot of malices there. So, yeah, we did lose a couple thousand more than they did. And England is not that big. I should be able to follow up on that army. I'm just going to chase them. Only 26k, so it's just over half. I can reinforce in their territory, but it's not as much. And the further you are away from your own, it gets less and less to the point where I think nothing. Navies. What's going on? Maybe it's the one that I ordered to can replenish that one. Where is my fleet? Yeah, their navies are like little vultures in this game. They'll come after you. Like, we did lose that ship. So, we can't go past Yorkshire, so I don't know where their army went. There it is. It's up there. We don't have the numerical advantage that I would want. But their morale is low. Okay, why did we... Oh, our emperor died, so we lost a stability point. So Dalen Adelard. He's better at military. Okay, so Cunegun. What? Is that his sister? That's definitely a... Yeah, I think it is a sister. Emperor of the province, Yedisan, is now considered part of our... Okay, so we have that, coordinate. We won here. We actually... It's a pretty good victory, even though they had almost as many soldiers as us. Well, we had about almost 26,000. They had 18,000. I think that we should get out of there, come back, and destroy this army. Okay, so... Yeah, I think right away that we could get a stability point. Nope, we cannot. Oh, it's administration. It's not diplomatic power. So, to get there, we need 191. It's going to be a little while. Oh, we've taken London. Okay, this army can just go up there. 22% victory. Well, if that's the case, this guy, he has one siege, so let's put him here. This guy can wait there and replenish. Destroyed that army completely. Good job. Got another one in their army. This is our allies, is it not? Yeah. Destroyed it completely. Let this replenish. Doing pretty well, actually. They have low war enthusiasm. 31%. Yeah, it does add when you take a place at 31. So it adds a little bit, not much. And Kent is actually the target of the war. Oh, better get them back up. They're bringing their armies back. Our charge would be pretty devastating against them. Oh, destroyed every last one of them. That's devastating for them. Go there. You can go and take Kent. Where is our fleet? Sitting up there doing nothing. Okay, have it come down here so it can blockade. Take two of their provinces. Looks like they were trying to proselytize, probably trying to get rid of the Cathars. The Cathars are still there. Oh, no, we're only blockading one. I'd rather get their capital, which is here. This would get two. Sieges also go faster if you're blockading them by sea. That was taken. Let's go there, occupy that. If I could take these four, that would be really good. That's pretty aggressive expansion. So, I mean, the game only started not 10 years ago. And we have taken 4, 6. We have taken 10 if we take this. But it's okay. We do want all of Britannia. It's just that it takes a long time for these things, for these places, not only when they're cored, but for the, like, everything to calm down. So what am I getting per month now? 6, so that went down, administrative went down, diplomacy went down by 2 per month. Ooh, but military went up by 4. That's pretty good. It actually kind of evened out. Down 2, went up by 4. Okay, so they do have all 4 ships here. Go home at war, North Sea Fleet. Protect trade, North Sea, obviously. That's why I named it that. So this time I will remember, because I hated trying to figure out where they were supposed to be doing that. London is actually a good trade node, so that will really help in the long run for our trade and for income. This place has been taken. The best thing we can do is go after their capital. Is they, ooh, 13k. I think we should do it. No, they're leaving. Jeez, did they ever get a large army again? Yeah, I gotta come back. They might go right for Norfolk. Take out 1,000. I gotta destroy this army. It's important to get rid of the armies in the game. They're going to London, actually. Okay. August 5th, July 31st. So hold off for 6 days. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. August 5th. So they're moving in more forces as well. But they can't deal with 35,000. And our leader is better than theirs. Awesome. We annihilated their entire force. That's devastating. So we're at 56% war score. Unfortunately, somehow taken Oxford. Just occupying it. Okay, this guy can go take that, because it's really nothing to fight. And our general go up there. Take their capital. Oh, this is more of an army. This is their... Is it Mercia? One of their little guys. Good harvest, 1454 is considered a particularly good year for Germania due to good harvests, generating higher incomes than ever before. Ooh. We could use the administrative power as opposed to 873. 50 administrative power, yeah, I know, it's a lot of money. We could have paid off the loan too. Anyhow, administrative power, definitely. That's a hell of a lot of money. Probably because the size of our empire is so large. Usually I'm used to it being like maybe 200. But I don't see any armies left of theirs. We kind of probably depleted the entire countryside of manpower. Mercia still has men. Once we get their capital, they'll be really screwed up. Forget England. And we'll take money from them. So let's go up here and take this. This is Mercia here. This is Huys. Those are two of their little allies. I think they've got this guy up here as well. Lothian. Lithuania has canceled the right. Okay. Oh, what's going on? Lithuania lost badly. They're being gobbled up by Finland. Finland kicked the tar out of Norway. Well, in this kind of war, I could actually tell Sweden that, yes, you will get territory. That's the next war I'd like to do. But I think we may be moving too fast. I don't want to get penalties all across the board. Okay, we can still keep on building marketplace, but we have a loan to pay off, so it's not helping because we're at war. There's the English army, 1,000. Not much. So we are sieging 3 of their forts. What is this? Fleet? It's just called First Fleet. Oh. Yeah, these are heavy ships. Why do we have extra? Well, anyways, I'm not going to argue with that. Let's see how much more of a fleet we can build. We're actually over the limit. That's no good. It's costing us 6.70 a month. I thought that we had room. Well, what I'm going to do is you can actually mothball ships. You don't have to pay for them. And they just lose... Wait, I thought that these guys had men... manpower. I thought that they did. Unless that's with the upcoming patch. Yeah, there's a patch where they actually have... It's like 200 guys for heavy ships and 50 for light ships and so forth and stuff like that. And you actually have to make sure that they're all filled up with sailors. You can use press gangs to get... this is actually what they used to do. Used to go aboard in ports and use press gangs coming from the big ships and go out. Press gangs are just guys that go out and bring whoever they can find, any able-bodied man that they can see, and kind of make them forced slaves. It's actually really... it is a form of slavery, because you have no choice. So at gunpoint or sword point, whatever, they'll make you go on your ship. And you have to man the oars or whatever, man the ships. That was actually one of the biggest... not the biggest. It was one of the reasons why the War of 1812 took place, where the U.S. was ticked off at England for constantly going in their port towns and using press gangs to enforce their... I guess they're needed men on their ships to man it properly. Yeah, press gangs are nasty. In fact, they're also adding slavery. You can hit a place, I think it's 20 years. You can only slaving parties go aboard, like how North Africa used to do to all of the Mediterranean. It's pretty sad. A lot of people don't know that, just how bad it was for slavery in the Mediterranean. Sicily was a huge... place for once the Islam took it over. It was a huge center for slavery. So was Andalusia here. What was it called? El Andalus? When it was mostly Muslim in Spain. But slavery, people, like a lot of the coastal towns were emptied. They didn't actually return to some point in the 1800s before they were fully resettled again. Which just goes to show you how bad it was. And the states, they're Navy was originally created to combat the Barbary pirates that were operating out of North Africa. I don't think it was fully stopped until Europeans invaded there, like Spain took Morocco and France took Algeria here and Tunisia. So that basically stopped it. Oh, look at this. I see a whole bunch of their ships. It's not that many, but under occupation of England. Wait till Yorkshire is taken. If we can find their fleet and destroy it. See, now it's adding an extra bark, so I don't understand. I thought that we had that. So that shouldn't... now that we've... oh, why is it still counting? If I mothball them. Maybe it's not fully mothballed. It goes down to like zero. Probably speed things up because nothing's really happening. Scotland is declared on England. Well, this put a real stop to them at expanding their kingdom here. Nobility estates modifier granted, generalship expired. Their influence is now 51%. Oh, to hell with you, England. I'm gonna try to get around 100%. I'm not going to take mass territory for them, but what I will do... actually, I should take this as well. Just kind of make this all of southern England mine. I should, German particularis. I'm not sure what that is. Let's see, I understand Finnish separatists and Polish separatists, but... well, they want to increase autonomy. Show different means to handle the rebels. Boost stability. Oh. Yeah, there we go. Now we're at last stability, highest as it goes. Error, Eremer Zwarte Hoop? Discontent with the behavior of our troops in the region, the peasants of Frisia have taken up arms against us, joined by mercenary soldiers. These revolters have had limited success on land, but have already conducted some surprising maneuvers at sea. Indeed, the revolters are as much pirates as they are soldiers, and unless we put this thing down soon, shipping will suffer. Crush the traitors. Okay, so we've got two uprisings right here. Into core province, Newmark. Need to get up there quickly. Because if they take the county, then their chance of revolt lasts longer. I think we just took a place. Yeah, we did. Yeah, they've taken there. We're fighting there. Taking their capital of Yorkshire, we're at 89%. Hit their army here. Alright, go there. All the forts except for this one have been taken, so we can go there. Okay, now that they've taken, they've left. Are we being... I don't see where their ships are. See him. There it is, there it is. They're probably gonna run again. Caught them. It's the last of the British army, or English army, I can't say British. Be incorrect. Destroyed them. Probably should wait. Wait. Oh! They're gonna go in no matter what. It's just locked. Yeah, they should have waited. Naval supplies happen to us, naval force limit. That will help. I think that's what I had originally. But it's taken it up a lot, so it's only 185 a month that's costing us. So our income has increased. Let's see. Can I pay back that stupid loan? Yes, I can. Oh, it went down, probably because we paid about a year of it off. Okay, that costs us a lot. Naval supplies... Well, we had support from Brunswick. At least they helped with something. Okay, so that's against them. This is more of their army. This is Scottish army. Sorry, guys. I want all of the UK. I want all. Having that added to my empire, I think, would balance me out against the Byzantines, unless they start taking out mass territories. For all I know, they're going to go after India. Eventually. Thanks for the help, Brunswick. Okay, so, I'm not sure how long this video has gone on for. One moment. Well, it's gone on for 23 minutes or so I'm going to end the video here. Thanks for watching, and we'll continue on the war against England in the next video.